It seems that the prospects going forward are quite positive for a very strong recovery, similar to what we are seeing in other segments of the industry. And usually the tankers follow dry cargo and the container market, and this is happening as we speak, where we see unprecedented high levels for demand as infrastructure building is going back and it's happening. The same is evident a lot on the product carriers. A lot of refineries are shutting down in the Western world, and more demand for products is required around the world. A lot of coal mines are being reduced in places like China, and that helps our LNG and fuel imports in these vast markets. India, at the same time, is importing more and more from the West, or at least from places like West Africa, and it's not so dependent anymore on the Middle East, increasing ton miles as we speak, as we go forward. And the normal contenders like Libya, who has been a big participant of the Mediterranean market, has increased since our last presentation in November, another 16% is its output. So everything helps, and more importantly than anything else is the lack of supply, very small single-digit supply coming in over the next 2 years as we speak. So I think we are looking at a significant super cycle happening here sooner rather than later. At the same time, we are seeing large conglomerates like Equinor, which is one of our largest also clients, coming in and starting to work on what they say is the largest so far oil field in the North Sea, the Fram field, which is another sign that product is going to be there for the foreseeable future for the limited amount of vessels that are. Also, low inventories as we speak. People have been burning their cheap inventories, and I think they will need a significant uplift as we go forward.